Talking about some blues here. Another spotlight session here at the Guitar Spot. So over like your standard blues, your 1-4-5. Talk to you a little bit about outlining the chord shapes. So if I'm in just a standard blues, which is your one chord's an A7, your four chord is a D7, back to A7, and then up to E7, which is your five chord, down to D7, and then back to A7. So of course we can use your pentatonic type scale. That kind of sound. That sounds really cool. But there's also something really awesome you can do, and I hear guys like Matt Schofield doing it. You know, Robin Ford does it, of course. All the really hip blues guys do it, and they really signify on that if you're playing in an A, they're hitting the third note. Just adding that to your pentatonic alone is a big deal. And then when it changes chords, really trying to hone in on the third note of that chord. And you can hear the change immediately, what it does to the blues. So you might be jamming over a regular blues and you have licks like. But when you hit that major third, it just really makes your blues classy sounding. Change chords, instead of just playing the pentatonic, sliding into that third note of D is going to really make that sound hip too. So normally you would have this scale, instead you're adding this tone, which on over the D chord is an F sharp. And it makes you, you know, you really hear it immediately that chord has changed, you know? Now when it goes to the E, it's a G sharp. So. So let me outline those notes. So for the A chord, you got the one of the chord, the third of the chord, which is a C sharp, the E note, which is the five, the dominant seventh note, which is G, and then A. When it goes to this chord, you have these tones. Fifth fret, which is the D, the F sharp, the A, a dominant seventh here, which is a C, and an E is part of the nine chord, so you can use that tone too. to the one chord. So it just has a really nice sound. Hip sound, and I'm gonna walk through a couple licks using that same idea. So the over the one chord, so let me play it again. So really slow. Now for the four chord. So really slow. And you're back to the one chord. Now you can use that same lick I just used to move it up two frets for the E. And then back to the original lick. So you might have. It's really cool. So some neat blues ideas for this week. Again, make sure you learn your pentatonic scales. And I think adding those color tones, instead of trying to learn a whole bunch of new scales, adding the color tones to the chords is a really hip way to jazz up your blues. So hope you enjoy that. Take us out with some blues.